Hi guys, it's Sam from Creatively Sam's. Welcome back to my channel. I'm so glad you stopped by. Today's Tasty Tuesday video is sweet and sour red cabbage. The first time I tasted this, I was in my teens, and it is definitely one of my favorites. So if you want to see how I did this, stay tuned. It's coming up next. Okay, what you need is either a half a head of a large red cabbage or a small head of red cabbage. I've got a small one. 2 to 4 tablespoons of butter. 2 tablespoons of Splenda or sugar. 1/4 cup of balsamic vinegar. Some sea salt. Some black pepper. And some crushed bacon. Okay, the first thing I'm going to do is slice the red cabbage into thin slices. Okay, I got the butter melted and I'm sauteing the thinly sliced red cabbage. And I'm going to put a lid on this. And I'm going to come back every minute or so and stir it. But it's got to saute for about 5 minutes. Now we'll be back after that's done. Okay, the 5 minutes is done. And now I'm going to add the 2 tablespoons of Splenda or sugar, whichever you're doing. And the balsamic vinegar. And mix this well. And I'm going to put the lid back on. And I'm going to simmer this on a low heat for 30 minutes. And I'll be stirring on occasion. And you can see how much this is already cooked down. I know it looks like a whole lot when you first start. All right, put the lid on and I'll be back in a half an hour when it's done. Okay, while this is cooking, I thought I'd show you a little trick that I learned a long time ago. I've got a plastic zippered bag, lunch bag. And I put the bacon in there, and if you rub it back and forth like you're doing laundry, it crumbles it without the mess. Okay, 30 minutes is done. I'm gonna turn the flame off. That's nice and soft. Okay, I'm going to add a little bit of salt. This is sea salt. Put in whatever you want. And a little pepper. And I'm going to add the crumbled bacon. And this is not necessary. I worked at a German restaurant when I was 16, and this is the way they made it, so that's the way I learned. You just want to toss it up very well, and then once this cools, I'm going to give it a taste, which needless to say, I can't wait to get my mouth around this. Well, it's cooled down, and I'm going to give it a taste. I think I could have used a little more vinegar, but this is almost exactly the way it was when I was a teenager. So if you like what you saw, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and happy creating, everyone.